Now, hello there. Oh, sorry. Now, I hope you're doing well, wherever you're watching me from. Now, today I want us to look at series and parallel connection of resistors in an electrical circuit. If you have more than one resistor in an electrical circuit, how do we find their combined resistance? Of course, resistors can either be connected in series or parallel, or we can have a combination of both series and parallel within one circuit. Now let's have this. So let's look at resistors in series first. Now this is the circuit we're going to use. So we have resistor 1, 2, 3 with their resistance as indicated. So how do we know how to calculate? How do we calculate the total or effective, or we can call it combined resistance of the following resistors? Now there are two important information to note. When components are arranged in parallel, in series, when components are arranged in series, there's something here to note. The potential difference across the component we're arranging in series, when you add them, should give you the total potential difference across the battery. So this voltage here, V1 plus V2 plus V3 should be equal to the total voltage, which is V. So let's say the voltage across the battery is V. Now many students have challenge in explaining or getting this concept here. Remember, when you're talking about resistors which are having different resistances, the current that is flowing from here should be the same current that is flowing to the other side. Why? Because charge is conserved. So the amount of charge that is flowing through the resistors should be the same. There's only one path for the current to flow here. Now, if let's say resistor 2 is having high resistance, what does it mean? It means more energy will be needed to push the charges to pass through that resistor. And therefore, it means there will be more energy. And energy of the push is what we're calling the voltage or the potential difference across that component, which is the resistor. Now, Roman 2, the law of conservation of charge. Charge is conserved, so the charge that is flowing from the negative terminal should be the same charge that is will be here at the positive. Or in other words, the current from the positive should be the same current to the negative. So if we could have another ammeter here, this ammeter should have the same reading as this ammeter here. If you have a challenge in connection of components in series, kindly watch the video that you can able to see, it's linked above there. Now, if the current is the same, so the same current here will be I, the current flowing here will also be the same, the current flowing here will be the same, the current out will also be the same. So if the current through R1 is L, so that means the total current I is equal to the current flowing through resistor 1, which is 1, flowing through resistor 2, which is that, should be the same current flowing through resistor 3. Now, how do we proceed? We remember or we recall. So you need to recall about the Ohm's law. So V is given by IR. So V is given by RR. So from here, if we want to find the total voltage, total voltage V is given by IR. The voltage across R1, we can call it V1, is given by I1 times R1. Similarly, V2 is given by I2 times R2. V3 is given by I3 times R3. So therefore, the total voltage V, which is IR from here, so IR is equal to the voltage V1, which is given by I1 times R1. So I1 R1 plus V2, which is I2 times R2 plus I3 R3. Now, as we have mentioned, I is equal to I1, which is equal to I2, which is equal to I3. Current flowing through them is the same. So therefore, we'll have IR is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus I times R3. Then we apply mathematics, we factor out I. So we'll have IR is equal to I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this I cancel I. So therefore the effective resistance, when resistors are connected in series, what do? We just add, we just find the sum. So when resistors are in series, to find the total resistance or the effective resistance, we just add. Let's look at resistors in series, in parallel. Now, this resistor 1, 2, 3, they are in parallel. Why? At this particular point, there's a junction. Current flows from positive towards the negative. Now, when current reaches at this particular junction here, part of this current can flow through R1, so we can call it I1. Part of it can flow through I2, so flow through that, and then another current flows through here. So it therefore means, because current into the junction is equal to current out of the junction. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So about the current, when components are arranged in series, then the current that is flowing into the junction is equal to the current out of the junction. Now, what about the potential difference? When components are arranged in parallel, you can able to see these components, they have direct contact or direct link to the power. So if the voltage here is V, this resistor 3 is connected directly to the power supply. If we remove R3 and R1, you can able to see clearly R2 is still having a direct contact to the power supply, same as R1. And therefore the voltage across the component, regardless of their resistance, they will have the same potential difference. Now, from Ohm's law, V is given by IR. Therefore, from here, I is given by V divided by R. So that means I is the total current that is flowing. So that will be given by V over total resistance. I1, that will be V, because voltage across the component is the same. So that will be V over R1, V over R2, V over R3. Now this maths, we now factor out V from here. So we'll have V over R is equal to V, V into 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. So V cancel V. So we'll have 1 over combined resistance is given by 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. Now, so if resistors are connected in parallel, then to find the effective resistance, this is the formula that we use. Now, let's have maybe a simple example. Let's say R1 is maybe 5.0 ohms, R2 is maybe 7.0 ohms, and then R3, let's say, is 3.0 ohms. So how do we find the effective resistance here? So this will be 1 over RE is equal to 1 over 5 plus 1 over 7 plus 1 over 3. So I'll just use a calculator very fast. So 1 over 5 plus 71. So this is giving us 71 over 105. Now this is where most of the students make a mistake. After getting this, after adding this one here, they always take this value as the value of the resistance. Remember, this is 1 over RE, 1 over the effective resistance. So to find the resistance, we find the reciprocal. So this will be RE over 1 is equal to 105 over 71. But we give our answer into decimal place unless the question state otherwise. So that will be 1.479 ohms as the R. So the effective resistance, when they're in parallel, that is what we do. Now, there's a special case. Suppose the resistors are only two. So there's a special case here for two resistors in parallel. Let's say that is what we have. So if we have only two resistors, remember what I want to show you here is only when resistors are two and they're parallel, as this can be able to see here. We already proved that if you want to find the effective resistance when they're parallel, so to find the effective resistance, we just get 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. Now, if you can remember this is maths. If you have something like this, 1 over 3 plus 1 over 7, the LCM here is 21, so we can just have 3 times 7. So what do we do? So 3 goes into this product 7 times. 7 goes into this product 3 times. So our answer is 10 over 3 times 7, which is just 21. I want us to use this knowledge here. Now, the LCM between R1 and R2 is just the product. So that is R1 times R2. R1 goes to the product R2 time. 3 goes into this 7 times. Just pick the other one. So that is R2 plus R1. So 1 over the effective resistance. Remember, we want effective resistance. So we find the reciprocal. So that will be RE over 1 is given by product R1 times R2 over R1 plus R2. So dividing by 1 is just the same value. So when two resistors are connected in parallel, you just find the product over the sum. Product over the sum. Let's prove it. Suppose R1 is 5.0 ohms, R2 is, let's say, 7.0 ohms, then So from here, we're going to use two formula, this and then this. So let's start with the first one. So that will be, so 1 over Re is equal to 1 over 5 plus 1 over 7. So 1 over 5 plus 1 over 7. I'm getting, so this is 12 over 35. That means the effective resistance will be reciprocal of that. Reciprocal of that in decimal place. That will be 2.917 ohm, or approximately into two significant figures, that will be 2.9 ohms. Now, suppose we use this formula, the product over the sum. So instead of going all those process, we can just use this. Let's confirm. So the effective resistance here will be the product, that is 5 times 7 over 5 plus 7. Now that is 35 divided by 12. You see, that is where we have. So we have skipped this particular. We are actually here already. We already found even the reciprocal. So the answer, 35 divided by 12, we are getting approximately 2.9 ohms into two significant figures. So whatever you're watching, if you have a challenge, kindly keep on watching this video as many times as you can until you get the point right. Should you have further questions from here, if there's something that is not making sense, kindly leave a comment and reach us. Now watch the next video. So we're going to do a few examples. Watch the next video where we're going to use these equations to solve some questions in various curriculum, 844, IGCSE, AIB, and Cambridge General Exam, all of them. So see you next time. Take care. Kindly, if you're new here, remember to subscribe. Bye. Take care.